Unless you were living under a rock for the last 6 months, you probably heard of Mushoku Tensei or Jobless Reincarnation. Okay, let's be real, no one calls it Jobless Reincarnation. It's the most popular anime of this year, and not just cause it's an isekai that has something new to offer, but it also has boobs. A lot of them. I mean, great plot, great animation, and interesting characters. It's a pretty basic isekai, but that is exactly why it works. The world is simple, the story is simple, the characters are simple, yet what matters is that these are done well. To make a good isekai, you don't need an incredibly unique story, but you just need to do well whatever worked before. That's what Mushoku Tensei is. Season 2 has started airing a few weeks ago, and I have been really enjoying watching it totally legally.
Just sign the damn contract, Funimation!
The last few episodes of Mushoku Tensei Season 1 was solely focusing on the turning point. About Rudeus and Eris getting teleported into the middle of nowhere without a sign of anyone familiar, and the only help they can rely on is from a person known as the biggest threat to the whole world. The pacing, the storytelling completely changed and the focus completely shifted onto just three people, throwing everyone else out of the way like they never existed, and going from what seemed like a slice of life to a plot where every decision matters. When Rudeus and Eris woke up after the incident, they could have easily just decided to leave it at Ruigerd, considering that they have been told throughout their whole life that the Super Earth is dangerous. Yet they chosen to trust him just because of a little act of kindness. Like, I mean, who wouldn't trust a person in a matter of minutes that literally everyone in the world is scared of? Oh, that's how their journey begins, and that's how the suffering will slowly start to build up, as they get further and further. They have to face with the fact that how cruel the world itself is, with the fact that you can do everything correctly and still fail. From the outside, it just seems like an adventure, and it's not entirely wrong. They are going from city to city, experiencing different type of cultures, getting horny from every single girl that he sees. But at the same time, it's also mentally challenging, and especially Rudeus has to realize that being the good guy isn't always the best option. They just can't help everyone. They just can't save everyone. For them to progress, they have to adapt to the fact that they have to focus on what's best for them and not what's best for everyone. At the end of season 1, they throw away everything they had and reveal that Ruigerd is a super. They did what they most feared of, but at the end it was their best option. Yes, now everyone knows in that city that Ruigerd is a super, but now they can continue moving to the next city without a problem. Season 2 continues building on the same format. They continue their journey going from city to city, but the pacing slows down and put both them and the viewers into a much more comfortable position, completely closing out the outside, all the way until they move to the next city, where Rudeus meets his father for the first time in a half decade, and beats the shit out of him. I feel like I was the only person that was like, yes, beat him up, show him that you tried your best! Oh, wait, no one is clapping? Is he in the wrong? Shit. This is the point where the story completely changes focus and reveals that how tunnel visioned both them and the viewers became. The main story, after Rudeus and Eris teleported into the middle of nowhere, was to find a way home, but it became less and less significant as the story went on, simply because it was never the main point of it. What the main story builded up on is all these small stories of different people. That is what drew us into the story. Like how cool it was to meet Ruigerd, realizing that the person everyone is scared of is just a normal human. Or for example, experiencing the life of these monster people. That Ghislaine grew up there. The cute doggy. That how different their life is compared to someone in the city. And the cute doggy. Out of all the episodes, these were the ones I was mostly invested in. Yet it has barely anything to do with the main storyline. Most probably we won't ever see these people ever again. Yet these are the stories that kept us interested in Mushoku Tensei. And not the factor of them getting closer to home. Or just anything that has to do before they got teleported. Unfortunately, the cost of that was that Rudeus and Eris completely disconnected from their families. Disconnected so much that they didn't even realize that there is no way home. It was always in front of them, yet they never noticed. I mean, how the hell did they miss that message for one whole year? How the hell did they just forget to write one single letter? Okay, watch this, I'm writing it for you, Rudy. Hey, Daddy. I'm in the middle of nowhere, somewhere on the other side of the world with a cute girl. The world's most dangerous person that you told me to be scared of is helping me to find a way home. While I really enjoy the anime, we can't disagree that it's nowhere near perfect. The world that Rudeus is in is not understandable at all. Like you just can't pinpoint where they are. You can't understand how big that world is, how far away they are from home, because there is not a single thing that would visually represent it. The ecchi in the show sometimes just gets way too far where you genuinely won't feel comfortable watching it. But still, the anime itself is amazing. And there are no anime that doesn't have any flaws. At the end of episode 5, Rudess had that moment where he realized that he completely forgot about everyone else, and this moment will change the focus of the story completely. But it will focus on the psychological side of it rather than actual progression. We already seen pretty much similar things in animes like ReZero, where no matter how much problems Subaru was able to solve, there were always something bigger. And it's basically the same thing in Mushoku Tensei. What Rudess and Eris did isn't bad by any mean. Yes, they did forget about their families, but they got teleported just like everyone else. How can you expect two kids on their own to think of everything? It took them one whole year just to move like four cities with the help of Ruigerd and the literal god on their side. Throughout this whole journey, the constant difference between Rudeus and Ruigerd was that while Rudeus tried to care about everyone, Ruigerd only wanted to focus on their own objective. Yet at the end, the exact opposite of that is what became the problem. Now how the story itself will continue is a huge question. It can go into multiple directions, but as an anime only, just as I said, the story will focus on psychology and the mental of Rudeus. I don't think he will just leave behind his family, and even if he would, there is no way the story could progress as flawlessly as it did, because mentally he will always just feel blocked. Mushoku Tensei is probably going to be the best anime of this year, unless something goes really badly, and I just can't wait to see how the story continues.